Hey guys, welcome back to my thoughts on Godzilla vs. Megalon. This is a film, guys. Godzilla vs. Megalon is probably one of the most well-known films in the series. As a matter of fact, this was a film that I saw probably more than any of them on television. This was like a Saturday morning staple in afternoon television. I mean, we had Godzilla vs. Megalon, which was shown quite a bit. And matter of fact, a lot of the 70s Godzilla films were the ones that we saw as small children, or at least my generation. But anyway, one distinction that Godzilla vs. Megalon has that none of the other Godzilla films have is that it was the only Godzilla film in the franchise that was actually broadcast on national television. The channel was NBC, and it was actually hosted by John Belushi, who actually dressed up in a Godzilla suit himself and offered commentary and comedy. So that was pretty exciting, being a small child and actually getting to watch that on television. Another thing about Godzilla vs. Megalon is the fact that it was really heavily influenced by Japanese television. As a matter of fact, Japanese superhero and robot television. The film actually came about as Toho held a contest with small children to see who could create Godzilla's next foe in a film. And that foe ended up being a robot, and the winning child actually drew a robot that was heavily influenced by Ultraman and another robot that was popular on television. So Toho initially decided that they weren't going to make a Godzilla film, and instead, given that superhero robot themed shows were really popular, they decided that they would make a Jet Jaguar movie. And Godzilla was actually not going to be in that film at all. But luckily for us, Toho started doing some initial tests of the character of Jet Jaguar, and they found that audiences weren't really too taken by the robotic character. So production was shut down on a Jet Jaguar film. It never came into being. So a little bit later, guys, Tomoyuki Tanaka took a look at the Jet Jaguar proposed production, and he pretty much surmised himself that, you know, this is a character that, you know, probably couldn't carry an entire film by itself, and, you know, it just, he didn't have the charisma. So he decided to add Godzilla in the film, and he thought, you know, people like Godzilla, so if we have a combination of Godzilla and a robot, which is really popular on television right now, we would have a winning combination. Now, of course, Mr. Tanaka had also created Ultraman, and it was really, really popular at the time with kids. So he combined the two, and in his mind, he thought, you know, this is going to be one heck of a movie. So he got his second tier production team, which consisted of Jun Fukuda, who would go on to direct the film, and they went to work on Godzilla versus Megalon. And a lot of people don't know, but they actually had started production on a Jet Jaguar film. They went about 3 weeks into production before they actually closed the production down. And when Tanaka came along, he reopened the production, adding Godzilla. And this is probably the most quickest filmed movie in the franchise, because once Godzilla was added to the mix, they only filmed for 3 weeks. So the entire production took about 6 weeks to get this film up and running before it was released. Now, pretty much fans are split on this film, guys. This movie was actually lambasted on Mystery Sci-Fi Theater 3000. It's been on there lots of times, as well as some of the other Godzilla films, but this one was particularly a favorite that they love to make fun of. And fans are pretty split on the movie. Some fans like it and some don't. The biggest criticism seems to be that some fans feel that, you know, this is a poor representation of Godzilla, and that it's much too kid-friendly, and that, you know, it's just riddled with moments that are just ridiculous. One being the flying kick that Godzilla does in the film. The flying tail kick, where he runs, jumps on his tail, and just slides and kicks Megalon. But now, the movie also had Gigan in it, and Gigan was an added bonus. So, you know, I'm pretty split on the film too as well, guys, because by this time, the production values were pretty much shit. There's not very many visual effects in the film at all. This movie is loaded with stock footage. And the stock footage is just so ridiculous. I mean, we actually have stock footage once again of the Maser tanks, where we have, it was either Megalon or Gigan. One of them fell to the ground and hid behind trees, hiding from the Maser tanks. And we have that same scene from War of the Gargantuas, where the evil Gargantuas hiding behind the trees trying to avoid the Maser tanks. And even more so than that, guys, we have a shot from Godzilla versus Gigan, where in that film, the Air Force attacked Gigan, and he was leaping up, hitting the planes with his claws. Well, in this film, we have Megalon actually being attacked, or not Megalon, yeah, Megalon actually being attacked by the Air Force, and he jumps up to hit the planes, and if you look closely, you can see it's Gigan's claws from Godzilla vs. Gigan actually hitting and destroying the plane. So, cost-saving, but definitely painful for the film, guys. And I gotta tell you, you know, if we round out the cast in the movie, the cast is pretty mediocre as well. Really nothing special about these people at all. Kind of odd if you ask me. And as a matter of fact, guys, rumor has it, and I don't know if this is true or not, but rumor has it that the two male characters in the film were initially supposed to be a gay couple. And I don't know if that's true or not. That's what kind of has arisen from all this. It could be hearsay or whatever, but initial thoughts of the film after all these years is that these characters were supposed to be homosexual. But anyway, moving on from that, guys, the film doesn't really boast anything unique or special. I will say that there are some decent miniatures in the film at the beginning when Megalon destroys a dam. When the river or the lake is sucked dry, that looks pretty doggone cool. But other than that, you just have a ton of stock footage. Godzilla looks like a big puppy dog with puppy dog eyes. And it's just definitely, like I said, a film molded for children. So, you know, at the end of the day, guys, I don't hate the film. I think that it's fun to watch. There's not very much plot in the movie. There's not very much special effects. There's a lot of stock footage. I guess it kind of has a nostalgic kind of value to me. I enjoyed the film as a kid, and it pretty much carries over. Well, like I said, I don't hate it. It does have its ridiculous moments, and the stock footage only served to bring down the movie. I mean, my goodness, film some new stuff, Toho. But other than that, I can enjoy it on a bad day when I just want to see something that's kind of funny. You really can't take it very seriously. So, you know, while I just can't recommend it, I would say that it's not totally bad. But anyway, guys, I'm out of here. And I shall see you at the next Godzilla movie review.